We're here live at Flexibus in Simonstown in Navan, and we're celebrating a fantastic day, which is a combination of a lot of energy and time and effort, which has made it that the rural links are really solid and in place. But I'm sitting beside this glorious woman, very glamorous, I have to say, as well, Anna May McHugh. I'm so delighted to be able to talk to you. You're very welcome indeed.
Thank you very much. I'm delighted to be here and to meet all the people from three big areas. There must be 300 to 400 people here today.
Well, you did a lovely speech inside, I have to say, because you are the brainchild, well, one of the most pivotal people I've ever seen in this country. When it comes to the National Ploughing Association, you have been there since you were 17, I heard.
Absolutely. I started at 17, more by accident than design, because the founder was a great friend of my father's, and he asked my father, would I give him some assistance in the office. I went down to the office, which was about 3 miles from me in Athy, County Kildare. And I just came home and I said, no, it's not for me. But I went the following day, and the rest is history.
Well, that history culminated in you actually writing a book called The Queen of Flowering, isn't that it?
Yes, I did. And I went back over all the years as much as I could think of. And, you know, it was very small when I joined. And, you know, J.J. Bergen, who was the founder, who was a Kildare man, he passed away in 58, and then I got more responsibility, and in 72 I was appointed managing director. I then felt I really had a weight on my shoulder, because it was up to me to make things work and to add things to the event, which we have, and you know, that has been very successful, like new ideas like the lifestyle show and the fashion show, which was a brainchild. Definitely I'll claim that one anyway. But I felt we needed something for the ladies coming, and that has gone very successful ever since then, since 84. So, you know, we have, well, I'd say the attendance now would include 40% of women, and there was 60 of the men. But I remember going to the ploughing when you could count them nearly on your two hands, the number of ladies that would go. There was nothing there for them, only ploughing, and of course they wouldn't be interested in the ploughing end of it, you know.
Was this the reason for the fashion show then? Did you think we have to have more for women here?
More for women, yes. And then we got ICA involved, of course, and the brown bread baking and other shopping arcades as well. And it means now that the men and the family can come, because there's something for the children, there's something for all the members of the family, really. You have the machinery and all of that for the, and the dairy sector is huge. And then again, for a different clientele altogether, we brought in the pony games and the hunt chase in 1995. So really, as we went along every year, we tried as far as possible to, you know, increase interest and to add something on to the programme of events.
Certainly have achieved that over the years as well. And did you ever envisage that you would be where you are today as a result of that move when you were 17 years of age?
No, I never envisaged. I really thought that I would. I loved to do something in shops, I thought. But strange now as it may seem, from the age of 14, I was very involved in the junior section of Meath Fingal, which was very much alive in our village, where we had different sections. We had a junior section, a section for farmers, a section for the business people. And I became very involved in organising at that stage. And I can say nearly now that I'm involved in everything except the men's fidelity. You know, you get involved and known to yourself in community life and that. And I think, if you like organising, and I always have liked organising, to field days, sports, weekends and that sort of thing. But I never envisaged that the National Ploughing would go to the extent that it has grown today. It's absolutely enormous today, huge event for overseas visitors as well. And, you know, when I started, it was so small, and it was only bit by bit that it has grown. Sometimes unknown to you that you didn't expect it to grow that, but it did. Now, I would not like to see it get any bigger, you know, because we're able to manage what we have and perfect it. If that would be my intention.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, from small acorns, isn't that the way it
yes,
goes?
Yes, true, true. You know, it was very small. If I say to you, the records show that the first event cost £9.03 and 5p, and today you're talking about a cost of over 6 million. So that's the growth of it in financing and expensing that, because we embraced a lot of events, and that costs money. But at the same time, you get great attendance.
And there isn't one person in this country who doesn't actually know about it at this stage, because it was on my children's lips the last day. They were all excited, and some of the kids were heading off with their daddies down to it. Yes. So it's a real celebration. I do think we need more of that in Ireland.
We do, and you know, if we want to keep rural Ireland alive, you know, the event is held down in the middle of the country. We're going to Carlo next year. But when you see all the hospitals coming out to promote what they can offer, the schools, the universities, and it's very educational too, because you have all the government departments there, you have Chagas there, and you have the Met Office and all the people. And it's, from that point of view, it is very educational.
And you made a really valid point inside as well. You said how many children out there on their iPhones and their iPads, and, yeah. And this is a singular event that you have them getting up in their tractors or going into the fashion show.
Absolutely, you have, and it gets them away from the other thing, because children, they'll sit in the corner all day looking at the machine, and that's the life that they see. But there's far more to life than that, to get out there in the open air, to see what's going on in rural Ireland, to keep it alive, and that's very important. And as long as we can strive, look, it's sad to see post offices closing. It's very sad to see banks closing down, and you know, you're expected now to do nearly all your business through the hole in the wall, as I would say. But you know, a lot of things have changed from my time. Nonetheless, you have to let children know that there's more to the world and living than this machine in their hand and their iPhones and all that. And they feel they have to have it because of peer pressure. And they're going to the national schools at 8 and 9 years of age, and they come home and say, look, so-and-so has such a thing. Why don't I have it, mammy? Why don't I have it, daddy? But that's the story, and that's the reality.
Yeah. Whereas we had the puddles, and we had the out in the wellies to get out there in the muck.
And we didn't have that. And I remember some years back, this clergyman, and he was out in Australia for years, and he said, told us now, and we were young parents at the time, and he said, that box in the corner, he said, will ruin us if we don't, you know, have a time for it and have a cut-off time as well.
Well, listen here, you're one of the people who's going to make sure that that doesn't happen because of what you're doing as well. And you know what, we printed off something early because it was so incredible, and I'm delighted to say you were made an honorary board member of the World Ploughing Organization. That's unbelievable. What does that mean to you now, after everything?
You know, I was the Irish representative at World Ploughing level, and we, the Irish team, have been very fortunate in the last number of years because we hold the world title at the moment. And that we won in Stuttgart in Germany there in August. But, you know, I was at a meeting, and the meeting was almost over when the chairman, who is a New Zealand man, he said, look, there's something I want to bring up now, and I want you all to pay attention. And sure, I was looking there thinking that it was some other type of business under any other business. Yeah. And when he said this, I was absolute. Do you know, for a few moments, I wasn't able to reply, because it's a rare thing to happen. Yeah. There was one other person, and he was from Amsterdam, and he is in a nursing home now. There was only one other member, made an honorary life member. And it was in recognition of my contribution to the World Ploughing. I'm there for a long time at national. We run the biggest national event. There are 33 countries affiliated to the World Board. And out of that, we would be the biggest national event by a lot of streets ahead of others. And it's not that we're better organisers, but we seem to get the crowds that other countries do not get. But when he announced that, I was absolutely, I had to just steady myself before I could stand up, where there was not the only men, and say, look, I was overcome by the announcement. I really was, and with great honour I felt for the National Ploughing, for the Irish Ploughing Association, not for myself really, but it means that I still go to the World Board. It would cost me nothing if I wasn't the Irish representative now, and I was just going as an honorary member. The World Ploughing would sponsor me all the way and all through the air ticket, and while you're in the country as well. But apart from that, not looking at that aspect of it, I was looking at the honour it was for me, and particularly for the National Ploughing Association, that they gave me that recognition.
And also as a representative of the female flowers, and anybody involved in that community as well. Lovely. Guys, we're here live at the Flexi Bus Celebration in Simonstown in Meath in Ireland, and it's just been such a pleasure. I could talk to you all day, Anna May, and I'm delighted. Congratulations, that's fantastic, and well done
you. Thank you, and I'm delighted to be here as well. Great turnout, and to see all the people. And as I said, get out and be heard, and make sure that you avail of the facilities that are there.
And Anna May said something very important earlier. She said, get up, get out, and get going. And we'll leave it right there.